Hey everybody, it's Frosty the Song Man. It is a hot July 27th, 2018. And I'm doing this outside today. A little bit sweaty, but I'll get through it. On this day in 1974, John Denver started a two-week run at number one on the U.S. singles chart with Annie's Song. The song was a tribute to his wife and was written in 10 minutes when he was on a ski lift. Also, another thing about today, this is a very special day. My niece is going to be born today, so my kids are going to get a cousin today. All right, so exciting day for me and my family. All right, today, Electric Dirt, Levon Helm. Yeah. I mean, you gotta buy this just for the cover. I mean, look how cool that is. Levon, the singer, kind of came up with the art direction for this. I don't think he drew it, but he came up with the idea. This is the final studio album from American musician Levon Helm, released in 2009. It's the follow-up to the Grammy Award-winning 2007 album Dirt Farmer. It made Uncut's list of 150, one of the best 150 albums between 2000 and 2009. This was listed as number 80, which is really surprising because there were so many great albums in the 2000s. Like Whitesnake's Good to Be Bad, Nickelback's The Long Road, and Jonas Brothers' Lines, Vines, and Trying Times. All right, it was recorded in Levon Helm Studios in Woodstock, New York. Some of the songs are covers. However, he does the covers very well in his own way. There are two Muddy Waters tunes, You Can't Lose What You Ain't Never Had, and also another song called Stuff You Gotta Watch. There's a song co-written by Jerry Garcia called Tennessee Jed, and a song by Randy Newman called Kingfish. The album was produced by Larry Campbell, who was born in New York City in 1955. And I want to bring Larry up because without him, I don't think this album would be what it is. I think Larry produced this in a way that made it great. And without Larry, this album would not be as good as it is without his contribution. Larry Campbell is a multi-instrumentalist that played in Bob Dylan's touring band from 1997 to 2004. He has also toured extensively with Levon Helm. Campbell wrote two songs. He co-wrote two songs on this album. Campbell was credited with playing banjo, fiddle, and pedal steel on the Black Crowes' 2009 album Before the Frost, Until the Freeze. Campbell has made guest appearances with Peter Wolf, Elvis Costello, Emmylou Harris, Roseanne Cash, and Phil Lesh and Friends. Over the past years, Larry has recorded with such artists as Levon Helm, Judy Collins, Linda Thompson, Sheryl Crow, Chris Castle, Paul Simon, B.B. King, Willie Nelson, Kinky Friedman, Little Feat, Hot Tuna, Cyndi Lauper, Katie Lang, and Roseanne Cash, among others. All right, so that's the producer, a very important element to this album. But the singer, Levon Helm, was born May 26, 1940, and died April 19th, 2012. He was probably most famous for being the drummer and one of the vocalists for The Band. It's actually a band named The Band. Helm was known for his deeply soulful country accented voice and creative drumming style, highlighted on many of the band's recordings, such as The Wait, Up on Cripple Creek, The Night, and The Night They Drove Old Dixie Down. I'm sure you guys have heard those. Those are big hits on classic rock radio. Helm was also an actor, appearing in Loretta Lynn's as Loretta Lynn's father in Coal Miner's Daughter, and as Chuck Yeager's friend and colleague, Captain Jack Ridley, in The Right Stuff, and as a Tennessee firearms expert in the movie Shooter. Levon Helm was born in Elaine, Arkansas. Helm grew up in Turkey Scratch, a hamlet of Marvell, Arkansas. Or Marvell. They might say Marvell, Arkansas. I'm not sure. His parents, Neil and Diamond Helm, were cotton farmers and great lovers of music. They encouraged their children to play and sing at a young age. Young Lavon, as he was christened, he was born Lavon instead of Levon, He began playing guitar at the age of 8 and also played drums during his formative years. He saw Bill Monroe and his Bluegrass Boys at the age of 6 and decided then to become a musician. Arkansas in the 1940s and 50s stood at the confluence of a variety of musical styles, blues, country, and R&B, that when merged together later became known as rock and roll. Helm was influenced by all these styles, which he heard on the Grand Ole Opry on radio station WSM and R&B on radio station WLAC in Nashville, Tennessee. Another early influence on Helm was the work of the harmonica player, guitarist, and singer Sonny Boy Williamson II, who played blues and early rhythm and blues on the King Biscuit Time radio show on KFFA in Helena and performed regularly in Marvell with blues guitarist Robert Lockwood Jr. In Helm's 1993 autobiography, This Wheel's on Fire, Levon Helm and the Story of the Band, Helm describes watching Williamson's drummer, James Peck Curtis, intently during a live performance in the early 1950s, and later imitating this R&B drumming style. Helm established his first band, the Jungle Bush Beaters, while in high school. Helm also witnessed some of the early performances by Southern country music artists, blues and rockabilly artists such as Elvis Presley, Conway Twitty, Bo Diddley, and fellow Arkansas person Ronnie Hawkins. At age 17, Helm began playing in clubs and bars around Helena. In the late 50s, Helm joined the band The Hawks. Members of the band had difficulty pronouncing Levon's name, so they called him Levon. In the mid-60s, The Hawks were the backing band for Bob Dylan. After that, the band settled in Woodstock, New York, and simply called themselves The Band. Helm had dubbed the band The Crackers. However, when Robertson and their new manager, Albert Grossman, worked out the contracts, the group's name was given as The Band. The band's 1968 album, Music from Big Pink, catapulted them into stardom. Rick Danko and Robbie Robertson were among his fellow members of the band. An interesting side note, Rick Danko has put out some good albums too, worth checking out. And Helm performed with Danko in 1990 at Roger Waters' epic The Wall Live in Berlin concert in Germany. Bear with me, almost done. Helm met his future wife, Sandra Dodd, in 1975 in California. Helm and Dodd were married on September 7th, 1981. They had no children together. Kind of sad. In 1993, Helm published an autobiography entitled This Wheel's on Fire. I already mentioned that. Sorry. I got a little crazy with the cut and paste there. All right, in 1998, Helm was diagnosed with throat cancer, which caused him to lose his singing voice. After treatment, his cancer eventually went into remission, and he gradually regained his use of his voice. After which, he recorded his 2007 comeback album, Dirt Farmer, which I mentioned earlier, and then this 2010 album, Electric Dirt. George Harrison said that while writing his 1970 song, All Things Must Pass, he imagined Levon Helm singing it. Elton John's lyricist, Bernie Taupin, named the song Levon after Helm, although the song is not actually about him. Both John and Taupin cited that they were inspired by Helm, Taupin saying in various interviews that they would go down to their favorite record stores and buy the band's records, along with Elton. Bruce Springsteen called Helm one of the greatest, greatest voices in country, rockabilly, and rock and roll. Staggering. While playing the drums, both his voice and his drumming were so incredibly personal. He had a feel on the drums that comes out of a certain place in the past, and you can't replicate it. And I agree with Springsteen. I don't necessarily agree with him on politics, but I agree that there's something about Levon that's very authentic. Authentic in a real way, not a put-on authenticity. So let me play a little bit from this album. Of course, it's gonna skip. Jerry Garcia. You got a blues number. song out of tune, but it doesn't matter. It sounds great. Drumming is just right in the groove. This is one of my favorite songs. This is called Growing Trade. This is about a farmer who used to farm. He couldn't make money.
To raise a family,
so he started going pot instead.
Till I was weary to the bone. But hard labor never bothered me. Lord, it's all I've ever known. Too many seasons of calamity and too much interest to hold me long. I'm half the size that I used to be. That is stone. The crowd's ain't worth the seed, and ten will only get you fine. The light's dark, I'm a fleeting. I can hardly keep them in line. I gotta do what I can to survive. I know the law won't be forgiven.
Growing Trade, one of my favorite songs on the album. This is Golden Bird.
In the mountains, I saw a bird flying way up high.
Nice song. Stuff you got to watch. Okay, this one's called White Dove.
In the deep rolling hills of old Virginia, there's a place that I love so well, where I spent many days of my childhood.
This is called Kingfish. This is a pretty cool song.
Well, there's 100,000 Frenchmen in New Orleans. In New Orleans, there are Frenchmen everywhere. But your house could burn down. All your babies could drown. Would a none of them Frenchmen care?
Then the beat comes in.
Should kick us like you. You know the campus do. Who's going to big party down at the Roosevelt Hotel?
Really cool song. You can't lose what you never have. I'll skip this. It's not one of my favorites, just for time's sake. I go away.
Early in the morning, when the church bells toll, the choir's gonna sing and the hearse will roll.
This is called Heaven's Pearls.
Everyone, but I hold them near.
wish I knew how it would feel to be free. This is a cold song. In conclusion, whenever I listen to this album, I kind of think about Levon at the end of his life. You know, he got over throat cancer for a while, came back, eventually took his life, very sad. Although he lived a long life and had a long music career, very successful music career. So I kind of think about, you know, this is his last album, his very last album he made in his home studio in New York. He was among friends. And I think he put out a very, very strong album. So, yeah, I don't like a ton of albums from the 2000s, besides that Whitesnake album I mentioned. All right, but this is one of my favorites. This is a very good album. I would get it, especially if you like Americana, blues, R&B, country, all rolled into one, rock and roll. Definitely worth checking out. I've listened to this many times. Okay, thank you. I'm Frosty the Song Man. I was thinking about naming these Red Radio Reviews or some catchy name like that. Check out my band, Hunkapuss, and yeah, look at the information below if you want to email me. Thank you.